I'm sorry. I honestly can't understand a word.
I said, remember when we started behind my brother's back, and you said, wrap it up, or else I'm going to get pregnant.
Yeah.
Who puts truck nuts on a Dodge Shadow?
Our whole society is just becoming increasingly sexualized in every aspect.
Adult Swim is home to great, innovative, and original shows. They let the creators take risks, and they have a great collection of programs to show for it. By the standards of traditional network TV, most of Adult Swim's shows would be considered hidden gems, and I don't mean that in a bad way. They air in the dead of night, and the content itself is experimental. I'm sure you've heard of Rick and Morty, Aquatine Hunger Force, and the Eric Andre Show. But what about the Adult Swim shows that are less popular, the ones with low airtime? How about the show with the least airtime in network history? The show I'm talking about is Tender Touches, and it's aired 10 times since its creation. Once for the premiere of each of its episodes. It also has the lowest budget in network history, coming in at around 40 to 50k for the first season. Today, I'm going to be focusing on a few of the elements that I think make this show truly unique. Its aesthetics, its style of humor, and the gaslighting of Bradley Milner.
Hey babe, I'm home early!
It's rare for an adult animated show to have a unique style. It's even more rare for that style to look good. Oftentimes, adult shows will adopt a style that's funny, but is grating on the eyes. Tender Touches isn't one of those shows. It has an art style that's pleasing to look at, and ultimately serves the show's themes very well, making it feel like you're watching a dream. Here's the art director, Lauren Payne, talking about her design process on the Adult Swim podcast.
I feel like, I don't know, with the blue line work, I wanted the show to have its own visual hook, I suppose. Like, with Rick and Morty, the characters, like, their eyes are all, like, asterisks. And then in The Simpsons, the character's skin, if they're white, they're all yellow. And then, I don't know, I liked the idea of a show having line work that just wasn't black.
Talking about the audio aesthetic of Tender Touches, the show's creators have said that they frequently chose to avoid professional actors, instead recorded with people that happened to be around on the day of. The end result being that actors frequently stumble over dialogue and delivered lines that sound awkward. While this might bring down the quality of other shows, it works perfectly for Tender Touches. Combining this with the previously mentioned simple color palette and low frame rate animation style creates an entertaining, dreamlike experience for the viewer.
The only thing back here are fast food napkins.
Tender Touches has been called a show without punchlines. And as pretentious as that sounds, I think it's true. The writers don't tell you what's funny through short pauses for laughter or witty comebacks. There's just long conversations about seemingly arbitrary topics. You watch the show and laugh at what you find funny. Here's an example of what I'm talking about.
I cut into a grapefruit the wrong way once, and I didn't even have to use a spoon. I just suckled on the wedges.
Wow, that sounds very efficient.
What do you mean you cut into it the wrong way? How did that happen?
So there's like a hemisphere, and instead of cutting along the hemisphere, there's like two dots on either end of the grapefruit, like the prime meridian of the grapefruit. I cut the prime meridian of the grapefruit, and so I got these two big wedges, and yeah.
There's no setup, and there's not much of a punchline, but I still think it's funny as hell, and I really, really, really love this. Because you see a lot of comedy scripts where writers will try to craft the perfect joke, they'll try to be like a comedic genius, and that works sometimes, and I think there's a lot to be said about doing that, because it takes a lot of work, and it's respectable. But at the end of the day, if you can just fire up a podcast and create a funny show with your friends or with your creative partners, there's a lot to be said about that too, and I'm really glad there's a show like Tender Touches that's trying to create a new style of television. Ultimately, I'd say that Tender Touches is very reminiscent of the Adult Swim show 12 Ounce Mouse, just in the lo-fi style of animation and the way the dialogue is recorded. You know, thematically, they're very different, and even the animation style itself, you know, color-wise, Tender Touches is much more pleasing to look at. But just as far as, you know, the plot points and what's actually happening, you know, there's not a ton going on, but it's still funny and it's entertaining to watch.
I feel like you're objectifying women.
I don't know of any show that literally gaslights one of its actors. The character Charlene is played by Bradley Milner, who got the part by calling in to Blood Feast when they were first recording the first episode of Tender Touches a few years ago. And since then, they've frequently told Bradley the wrong information, they fed him things that don't matter to the plot, and they have fucked with him. That's what I'm going to say. They fucked with him, and I think it's really entertaining to watch. And he's also always speaking through a telephone, which I just think really adds to the aesthetic of the, you know, the dream nature of the show. Ultimately, I don't know if the show would be the same without Bradley Milner. I really don't think it would. And here's a clip that I think perfectly represents what I'm talking about.
Like, you're inspiring a generation of women by playing this part, and you kind of need to, like, represent them well and empower them.
No, what's the matter with you? Don't put this part in the show. I know you're going to do it now, but please don't. Sorry, I know it's all in good fun, but, like, don't go out of your way to paint me as a sexist.
I almost hit that guy.
Tender Touches is the lowest budget and least aired show on Adult Swim. Being the lowest budget show on a network like Adult Swim is a rare honor. I just wish it had more airtime. The third season of the show premieres June 15th at midnight. The creator of Adult Swim, Mike Lazo, has said that the show is amazing, but it's too smart for people. I disagree. I'm not saying it's a dumb show, I'm just saying that if Tender Touches was given a fair shot, it would pick up an audience. Play it on TV more than once, and give it a bigger marketing budget. Let people know it exists. As of right now, Tender Touches is Adult Swim's newest hidden gem. And for the sake of the show, I hope that's a title it sheds soon. Hey, I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm going to be making another Adult Swim show analysis video every 2 weeks, so subscribe for more. And in the meantime, if you need something else to watch, check out the series I created called BSTV. It's a combination of Trailer Park Boys, Workaholics, and It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. There's a link to it on screen right now, and in the description box down below.